Get ready to match the stars. Scoey Mitchell. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Paddy Duke-Aston. Richard Dawson. And Paddy Deutsch. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Don't call me that.
Is everyone all right? I didn't mean to step on your jacket there. What's going on up here?
How are you?
You're smoking a cigarette. You're smoking a cigar.
I'm not smoking.
He's smoking.
I'm taking off my watch.
What? Hello, darling.
How's it going?
How come you're using your deep voice?
I don't know. I didn't notice. You know what I mean?
You didn't.
Toffee.
Her roots are red.
But not terribly.
I take it you're all ready to carry on. Let's say hello to Lauren Huntley. Hello, Lauren.
Hi, thank you.
Lauren is our current champ. She's won a lot of money, $700 so far. Now she's going to have a go for $5,000. Are you ready for that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll see if you get it or if you don't get it right after we see about this, especially for you. Here we are with Lauren Huntley. You ready? It's your second time up here.
Yes.
First time didn't work out very well.
Spectacular.
Yeah, but you got $700 now, and you're up there with the $500, and that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But in order to collect that, Lauren, remember you have to match one celebrity exactly. Which one will it be?
It'll be Richard.
It'll be Richard. Okay. You turn around here and face me, if you would, please, ma'am. I will get the $5,000 question out of the slot, and it goes like this. Blank Tracy. Blank Tracy. Okay. Now, Lauren, what answer would you like to give us which you think will match his in this instance? Blank Tracy.
Dick.
Dick Tracy. All right. If you're right, that means you'll have a total of $5,700. It's show and tell time, Richard. May we see your answer? She says Dick Tracy will match you.
No, I don't read comics, my love. And I just thought of that great American actor, Dick.
She says it's fun to win. Yes, indeed, it is fun. Okay, I hope you can put that money to good advantage, can you?
Oh, yes.
Oh, that's marvelous, Lauren Huntley. Okay, now, if you're ready to carry on, let's meet another player right now and welcome Herman Samuels. Hi. Okay, stop. Herman, you know Lauren?
I do.
Herman Samuels.
Right.
They tell me you prefer to be called Sam. Your nickname?
Yes, it is.
Where are you from, Sam?
Well, originally from Cleveland, but I'm living in Diamond Bar right now.
Right. What do you do?
Well, I'm an airline pilot, and I've been laid off for the past 21 months.
21 months?
That's right.
What's he been doing for 21 months?
I'm working for another company right now.
He's laid off. He's an airline pilot who's been laid off from his regular company for 21. Well, I hope you win some money here.
Yeah, I certainly hope so.
Because money can only buy happiness. Remember that, Sam.
Oh.
Are you ready for that? Okay, let's push this button. And there, yeah, there it is. Now, you make the selection, if you would, please.
Take B.
B. Here we go. New game, folks. You all ready?
Yeah.
Yep.
Charlie said, all the muggers were away at a convention, so I took a shortcut through the park. Just my luck, I got mugged by a blank. Do not look at me with that vacant stare, because
it couldn't have been a mugger, because they
panic strikes my heart when that happens. All the muggers were away at a convention, so I decided to take a shortcut through the park, and just my luck, I got mugged by a blank. Really? Oh, that's the winning thing for her that got her the $5,000. That'd be an interesting souvenir for you, Lauren.
Thank you very much.
All right. Everybody ready? Charles, are you ready?
I am ready.
Okay, here we go.
He speaks many times.
Herman. Charlie said all the muggers were away at a convention, so I took a shortcut through the park. Just my luck. I got mugged by a child. A child. Stop that. He's unemployed. Got mugged by a child. Well, that hadn't crossed my mind, but I suppose it's possible. Scoey?
They booed.
They booed his answer, a child.
You told them not to do that because he was unemployed.
That's right.
You better get a job, man, with them answers.
Would you like to show us yours?
Oh, yeah, I said a cop.
Got mugged by a cop. Okay. Brett, what do you say?
Well, I went all the way to the other end of muggers.
Cute.
Got mugged by a deranged nun.
You know, you are a case.
I imagine.
Oh, the way the Baptists are.
Charles?
I said mugged by a squirrel. Mugged by a squirrel, do you know what you say?
No, what do you say?
Ah, nuts.
Ah. When you get mugged by a squirrel. All right.
Oh, dear.
All the muggers are away at a convention, so I took a shortcut through the park, and just my luck, I got mugged by a child, according to Sam.
I said policeman because I told my kids not to say cop.
Oh. The policeman.
The policeman
now, Richard,
is our friend.
Are you the mugger or the muggy?
Well, I told my children not to say policeman, so I said cop.
Oh, okay. I do it every time. I got mugged by a child, according to Sam. Patty?
No, this person got mugged by a laid-off airline pilot.
Oh, you got with you, Sam? No, not a honest Herman Samuels. He'd never do that. Okay, so that's your first round question. We see how you do with yours in a moment or so. But right now, this is especially for you. Of course, naturally. You ready?
Yes.
All right, Lauren, this is your first round question. Everybody plays. The guests at the wedding couldn't believe it.
Really?
Really. During the ceremony, the little bride on the wedding cake was blanking. You know the little bride on the wedding cake?
Next to the little groom?
Yes, she was blanking.
Read it again, it's such a sweet
song. Oh, it's sweet.
I love it, just breaks my little heart.
The guests couldn't believe it. During the ceremony, the little bride on the wedding cake was blanking.
Oh, Jean, how lovely.
Don't look like that.
Scoey, you haven't come up with such terrific answers this week.
No. Terrific.
Very good, yes.
Is you the
muggy
or the
mugger? I do.
All right, everybody ready except Charles? Write it down. Put it in the slot, Charles, and we come over here. Lauren Huntley. Ready? The guests at the wedding couldn't believe it. During the ceremony, the little bride and the wedding cake was blanking.
Burping?
Burping.
The other one was sleeping, and sleeping didn't sound good. Sleeping wouldn't make them laugh.
No.
I mean, the guests at the wedding.
I see. They weren't laughing. They just couldn't believe it. They were incredulous.
But she was sleeping. They wouldn't believe
it. I see. Scoey, what'd you say?
Well, I didn't say that.
No.
What did she say?
She said burping.
Burping?
Burping, yes.
You got a chance to fly again, bro.
I said weeping. Weeping is good. Everybody cries at weddings, and so the little bride was crying there. All right, Brett.
I cried at both my weddings.
You did?
Yes, indeed I did.
So did he.
Perk up, honey. All is not lost. I also said crying.
Crying. Okay, Charles.
I also said crying. But it wasn't for the obvious reason that she was in love. Eat your heart out, Patty Duke. She wasn't in love or anything. She was crying because she was on such a cheap cake.
I must go to my dressing room.
Yes, of course. Now, are you ready, Patty Duke?
Oh.
Are you eating your heart out?
Oh, am I ever.
You can cry just like that. Bing, just turn it like on that. And the water flows.
You
there.
Devil.
All right.
All right. I said she was stripping.
Stripping?
You know.
That's really an interesting answer, though. Yes. Seemed like they would be incredulous at that, wouldn't they? Richard?
I'll second that. Stripping.
I'll second that. Stripping, yeah. That's a very good answer. Patty?
I said flirting avec the minister.
Oh, flirting with the minister, yes. Terrific.
Strike up a friendship.
All right, yes, they're good friends. Okay, now, so at the end of round one, it's zip to zip, isn't it? Now we go to round two and see what happens there. Sam, you ready?
Yeah, I'm going to try to start flying this time. Let me try B again.
You want to try B again?
Yeah.
All right.
I wish I were in B
again. The Indian rubber man said, who?
The Indian what?
The Indian rubber man said. He said, when I was a little boy, the kids in the neighborhood would stretch my nose and they would use it as a blank. When I was a little boy.
I hated every question this week without exception.
No,
that's
a good question.
Time.
Read it slow. I want to see if I can cry.
When I was a little boy, the kids in the neighborhood would stretch my nose and use it as a blank. That was spoken by the Indian rubber man.
I got it. You got it, Scully. Got it, Scully.
Is there an obvious answer to this?
Yes. No, that's
that
not. I like to think I have a crack at it.
The kids in the neighborhood would stretch my nose and use it as a blank.
Oh, I guess I'll just stick with this.
You've got one. I don't. Why am I waiting? All right, let's go. Sam, the Indian rubber man said, when I was a little boy, the kids in the neighborhood would stretch my nose and use it as a...
slingshot.
Slingshot is good. Now, he gave the perfect answer to that question. He is a perfect person. And now we will find out how imperfect you are. Brother Scully?
We brothers now, huh?
Yes.
Well, I guess if we're going to put it on the basis of perfection, yeah, we are.
Well, now that you own the bus, we're brothers.
You know, that was the dumbest thing. They used to make us ride in the back.
Yes.
Where we could watch them.
Yes. Yeah.
I said eraser.
They would stretch my nose, use it as a eraser, okay?
You ain't the grooviest group we've had today either.
Now, Brett, what have you got?
I'm as mad as a wet hen. What a terrific answer. Darn it all, I said rubber band.
A rubber band. Well, that's close to a slingshot. Same idea as you had, Charles.
Is it a match?
No.
I said slingshot.
Oh, very good. See? Did you give the perfect answer?
I did.
You did indeed. Now, Richard always gives the perfect answer.
Oh, cut that out.
Now, we can expect an imperfect answer. How do you do it?
I don't suppose you would accept this as a peculiar spelling of slingshot, would you?
No. Couldn't leave. Not at all. No chance for that at all. So where are we here? You got three there. And now, Lauren, you've got to match three to stay in the game, four to win. Ready? Everybody plays. Chiquita, the stripper, said... She said, I just went to the doctor, and he told me my feet are fine, but I have to soak my blanks in Epsom salts. Chiquita, the stripper, said, I just went to the doctor, and he told me my feet are fine, but I have to soak my blanks in Epsom salts. All right, put something on the cards. and we'll get on with it. You think about it, Lauren. Light, light, light. That low's three lights are on. These three lights are out. We are waiting for you to turn on your lights.
What is it again, please?
One more time. Dear me.
I know, the stripper.
No.
Chiquita, the stripper.
Okay.
I just went to the doctor.
Her feet. Go ahead.
Wonderful. I just went to the doctor, and he told me my feet are fine,
okay,
but I have to soak my blanks in Epsom salts.
Be still, my heart.
You're still fooling around there. Okay. Right. Right. Put it in the slot there. Put it in the slot, and away we go. Now, Lauren, Chiquita the stripper said, I just went to the doctor and told me my feet are fine, but I have to soak my blanks in Epsom salts.
Chest. Boobs.
Okay. You say that very timidly. You're also turning red.
Well, I'm a school teacher, and I didn't want to say the second one.
Oh, really?
Ruined my reputation.
The kids are watching you?
They will be.
Yes. Where are they? Oh, there they are. Oh, there. Okay. All right. She said chest or boobs. Boobs or chest. Yeah. What do you say?
I just can't bring myself to say things like that.
You can't?
No,
that's because you're a pure of heart.
Huh?
Yes.
I said her ankles, closest thing to her feet.
Oh. They are hostile.
Hey,
we can put you up in the studio overnight. You don't have to go home tonight, Scoey. Brett, what did you say?
I say that group's gonna get a whole bunch of letters from the NAACP, and it serves them right. Hang in with me, honey, with buns.
Buns! Well...
No, and you're gonna get a letter from the Protestants, too.
What do you got, Charlie?
You're a pretty angry chick, you know? No, I mean it, baby.
What do you got there?
What?
Show us your answer.
Boobies.
Boobies. So, you need four more or two pair to tie. Yes. Well, that's two. Three to two there. All right, Richard, what are you offering?
I want all of the students to turn away from the set. Just one moment.
Boom! So at this moment, Lauren and Sam, the score is tied, 3-3. And it's entirely up to Patty Deutsch. Whether the game ends in a tie or a win.
Having had a parochial school education, I set her tassel twirlers, also known as boobs.
That wins the game. Okay, please stand by for a moment, Lauren. Sam, it was great to meet you. We've got gifts for you, and I hope you get the steady kind of job you want soon. You're a terrific guy.
Hope so. I had a lot of fun.
Now, while he's spinning off, we'll spin this message for you.
Oh, whoa.
You guys all ready? Okay, move in here with these cameras, and let's get this thing going here. All the cameras in? Okay, let's go. Lauren, you ready? We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. The blank company. Now, $500 if you match the top one, $250 for the middle one, and $100 for the bottom one. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
What do you say, Richie?
The electric company.
The electric company. A marvelous show.
Patty DeCosta.
Patty?
You said electric. Phone company.
The phone company, that's two.
Charles,
have you got one? It's difficult to be in the third position.
Oh, it's not. It's the gas company.
Oh, the gas company.
Eat your heart out, Lily Tomlin.
All right, so you got the gas company, the electric company, and the phone company.
Electric.
You want the electric company. Okay, let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal, if you would please, the $100 response. The Ace Trucking Company.
I used to be the truckette.
That's right.
I was the original truckette. Don't you know?
A little
All right, let's see what we got on the $250
response.
That's true.
The telephone company. All right, that was up there. Last chance for the electric company. Here we go with a $500 number. Yay! Okay.
We congratulate you, and before anything else happens, we got to do a little business with
them. All right, we just have time to thank all of you gifted people for being with us.
Oh, look into this shit.
Don't talk when the star's talking, Charles.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
You were splendid, and some of you will come back, and some of you will not. When we get together, these are the ones who will be here.
Orson Bean, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle.
Game 75. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Title Tales next over most of the CBS stations.